Evening, good evening, everyone. Yes, we come back here. Yes. Okay, after a long time, we are meeting once again. So, still some people have to come. We will not wait. Okay, we'll just revise the things what we learned in the last class. Yeah, I'm fine, Akhil. Yes. So, then we will go for the next things. Okay. So, can't hear really, Lipika. Others can hear, like only two people having facing problems of audibility. Just others can hear, so just check with your internet or the device, Lipika. Okay, so I'm ending the poll for this one. I'm just increasing my voice also for the better clarity. Okay, so we can continue with this side. And we are studying Animal Kingdom, and this is the fourth chapter. We studied the basis of classification, and we are going through the technical terms, right? So I told you those are very, very important. So in the last class, what we studied then? In last class, we studied about notochord. You know about notochord, right? What you can say? A hard structure which is present in an embryo stage or in some organisms throughout the life. Those actually give support to their body, right? Just one sec. One second. Yeah, I made you co-host. Yeah, got it. So yeah, so based on notochord, we divided into how many times? Divide into chordates and non-chordates, right? Yes, cartilaginous like heart structure. We don't say it is cartilaginous. We say it like cartilaginous like because it's not exactly same. These are related, right? Related words. So based on that, we divide into chordates and non-chordates. Yes. Thank you, Nishit. Okay. Yes. So based on the notochord, we divide into chordates and non-chordates. And later, that particular notochord is again taken into two types. Chordates are divided into two types based on the presence of the spinal cord, right? What's the spinal cord? It's a bony structure which is modified based on the notochord, right? It also gives the structural support to the body. Right, so we call it as spinal cord. Based on that, we again divide into invertebrates and vertebrates. If we just go for a classification, some people have a doubt also, so I'm just going through it once again. Animals can be divided into non-chordates and chordates based on presence or absence of the notochord. If there is absence of notochord, absence of notochord, then it will become non-chordates. There is no notochord, right? And if it is present, no, Abhishek, it's not same. Okay, so if it is present, it's chordates. Okay, so then these chordates can be again divided into invertebrate and vertebrates based on the spinal cord. Okay, based on spinal cord, or you can say backbone. Now it don't matter a lot, both look same. Okay, so if it is absent, then we call it as invertebrate. If it is present, then we call it as the vertebrates. Okay, sometimes what happens, non-chordates, you know, from periphera to up to the, you can go up to the echinoderms, all are included in here only, right? The non-chordates, right? So instead of seeing them non-chordates, some people simply refer them like periphera is an invertebrate. Okay, yes. So even though not exactly comes under these particular phylums, but some people use the words like this. Okay, so don't get confused. Invertebrate means there is no backbone, but having a notochord. But sometimes they refer like this also. So what you can say, interchangeably they can use it. So, but the correct way of saying it is non-chordate means without a notochord. Chordate means having a notochord. Invertebrate means having notochord but without having a backbone. Vertebrate mean having a backbone and also a notochord. Okay, so just a confusion. So somebody is asking, that's why I just want to clarify it. Okay, some people's or in some book they use the term invertebrates for the periphera echinoderms also. It's also not absolutely wrong. It's a common term what we use. Okay, we normally differentiate it, right? A scientific name and a vernacular name, same exactly like this. some of those English words are actually commonly used, but they are scientifically wrong. Okay, so same thing. And notochord is not a bone marrow. A bone marrow is a marrow means liquid, a liquid which is present in the, what you can say, vertebral column. That one you can call it as a bone marrow. Okay, those two things are different. And somebody asked, I don't remember who asked, what's the difference between a chord and a chord? C-H-O-R-D and C-O-R-D. Okay, I'm not sure about that. So when I go through the etymology, I told you, right, whenever you don't know the word meaning, you have to go for the etymology. Etymology will give you the origin of that particular word. Okay, so the thing is, both of these words arise from a single word called chordae. Okay, chordae, that means a stem. Okay, that means stem. So exactly, stem means a supporting structure. Here is also, both the words are derived from the same, but using those things are more restricted. In nowadays, chord is mostly restricted in musical instruments, but chord is used in the anatomical structures. Okay, anatomy. But why notochord left it like that? Notochord, why we are still mentioning a H instead of C-O-R-D? Okay. Yes. Why we mentioning a early H or another one H? Because this notochord, that particular word only is having a Latin origin. Okay. So those origin is kept it like that only. So notochord still have a C-H-O-R-D spelling. But other, where we use the later terms like narrow chord, okay, so all the other ways or vessel chord, always we will use the term C-O-R-D, not C-H-O-R-D, okay, but the meanings are completely same. There is no difference are there, okay. Chirant, according to Google, what notochord used in early classification? Yes, so that's also did in the older terms, but still we use that. Okay, still some of the people will use that. Okay, so we studied about these things, notochord and spinal cord. Then we went for a sexuality, right? Sexuality, what we saw. So it may be a what you can say, bisexual or unisexual, right? And different terms, hermaphrodites, monoecious, dioecious, all those things we studied. And we studied about sexual dimorphism, means having male and different male and female, like humans, right? So like humans or peacock and peahen, like that. And then we studied about body temperature, and some of them are poikilotherms or cold-blooded. That means they are dependent upon the environment for changing their body temperature, right? We gave a lot of examples, and in bird also I gave the example of one hummingbird. Okay, yes, hummingbird is correct only. And yes, warm-blooded animals, that means they can regulate its body temperature. Okay, it's mainly dependent upon the surface area to the complete mass ratio of the body, and also dependent upon the where it is living and how much energy it can spend. Okay, so it's like rich and poor kind of situation. Okay. Yeah, body temperature. Sachin, lions sexual dimorphism. Yes, absolutely. Lions show the sexual dimorphism, right? You can see the male with that hair, right? Complete hair you can see. And females don't have that. You can differentiate it. No problem, right? Sir, is there a correct opposite? No, we don't use one with a hermaphrodite. Homoprodite you can use, but we don't use the word. We only use the term hermaphrodite. Ha, main, correct, right? Main, absolutely. And fertilization process, it may be an internal or it may be an external, right? External, you can find it in the older organism, and internal in the higher organisms. So frog don't show the sexual dimorphism. Ananya, we can't say like that. Okay, some of the frogs do show the sexual dimorphism based on the presence of a special bubble-like structure below their neck and the coloration in some of them. Okay, so and having an extra thumb. Okay, so they show the sexual dimorphism. Okay, dogs don't. Yeah, dogs don't show the sexual dimorphism. Correct. Okay, then we went for the birth methods, right? Either it may be a oviferous, or it may be a viviferous, or it may be a oviferous. That means oviferous means egg laying, viviferous means giving birth to young ones like humans, and oviferous means it also give birth to the young ones only, but development without the placenta or without any connecting link. Development happen within a egg-like structure within the stomach only. So it's like an in-between stage. So we call it as oviparous. We can see it in shark and in some of the snakes like viper, right? That's why I put that picture. So this viper, it's a Russell viper. You can look that in here also, okay? So these are the things we studied in the last class. So one recall test came. Okay, I think everyone is super ready for the recall test. So we will see what's it. Simple. Okay. The question is Ornithorhynchus isa. Okay. Ornithorhynchus isa, a duck, a dinosaur, a monotreme mammal, a fossil bird. Okay. You have to choose it properly. I'm launching the poll. Okay, and who are in the Zoom can use the poll, and who are in the YouTube live can use the live chat. Okay, I really, guys. So we mentioned this. Okay, I mentioned the particular name also, right? I told that these kind of scientific words will be used, not the common terms. I told you, right? In animal kingdom, the crazy and very important thing is, indeed, they never ask about the common names, okay? Even though it may be a dog, it may be a human or whatever, okay? They will give the scientific words that makes you confused, okay? Even though you know the answer, you will get confused because you don't know the correct meaning or the vernacular name of that particular scientific word, okay? So, yeah, we will see. You have still 20 seconds. Yes, I'm getting mixed response in YouTube and also in the Zoom. Okay, we'll see who is correct, who is wrong. It's like a direct question. If you know, you can answer, otherwise it's difficult. And very, very, very less people are answered. I don't know, guys, answer quickly. Amrita, you can't say it like that. How it will be like that? Jeevan, correct, absolutely correct. No issue. There is no need to delete any responses. Okay. So you may give wrong, you may give correct. No issue. We know the song, right? Everyone make mistakes. So no problem in that. No, Amrita. I'm ending the poll now and I'm sharing the result. Very, very, very less people answered. Okay. 15% chosen option A, 25% B, 33% C, and 27% D. I'm stop sharing the results, and I don't know why very less people in YouTube live and only two people are answered in that. Okay, so we will see which one is the correct answer. Okay, what is Ornithorhynchus? Ornithorhynchus means what? First one, Ornithorhynchus means platypus. Ornithorhynchus means platypus. Now tell me, which is the correct answer? Duck-billed platypus. Correct, Lipika. Right? Duck-billed platypus. Then what is the correct answer? Everyone can choose this, right? Now, can you answer? So I'm just waiting from YouTube also. Real Akshay. Duck-billed platypus, bro. Not duck only. Yes, right. Everyone know that platypus is an egg-laying mammal, right? It's a egg-laying mammal. So if you know that it's a platypus, you can directly go for the option. It's not a duck, it's a duck build. That means even it will be something like this. Okay, it will have this one bills like this. Okay, but the body will be different. Okay, body will be completely different. Somewhat, it's looking weird, okay, but don't assume like this. Somewhat like this, okay, but that's why we call it as a duck build. Okay, I told you, right? It looks like half penguin, half duck. It's like crossbreed. Okay, don't take tension about that one. Okay, so it have a duck build. That means that particular beak is like duck. Okay, so this is not the answer. It's not a dinosaur also. It's not a fossil bird. It's a mammal. Then we got another question. What is the meaning of monotreme? Okay, what is the meaning of monotreme? Monotreme, or I'm just write down here, just remember this word, okay? So you may encounter somewhere else also. Group of mammals group of egg-laying mammals. Okay, group of egg-laying mammals. So what we did is, after the mammals, when we take the mammals, we divide into three different groups. Okay, some of the egg-laying mammals, so some of them are pouched mammals, some of them are placental mammals. Okay, we will learn that in later one. Okay, yeah, math class is also going on. You have to niche candidate should be in biology, and who are J candidate, they should be in there. Okay, math class. Okay, so. Egg-laying mammals means the mammals which gives the eggs, like echidna or this one, platypus, all those things, okay? And this one, pouched mammals, you know that, right? A kangaroo, all those things. And placental mammals means like us, humans, this one, cow, horse, all those things. So we differentiated like this. Monotreme means these are actually egg-laying mammal groups, okay? Egg-laying mammal group. So if you know the mammals, you can answer, but also remember the word monotreme. We will learn about it in the later class and also in the evolution in the 12th class. Okay. Yeah, beaked mammal. You can say it like beaked mammal, you can, but so it will be better. Egg-laying is a better word. Okay. Yes. So we will go to the next question. If you have any doubts regarding the question or the answer, just put a message in the chat box. Okay. The correct answer is monotreme mammal. So we are going to the next one. Next recall test came. Reproduction events in birds will be. Okay, they are asking how reproduction happens in birds. So option are internal fertilization and oviferous, external fertilization and oviferous, internal fertilization and viviferous, and external fertilization and viviferous. Okay, so I think this one of the easiest question, if you think. Okay, I'm just giving a 10 second time for you guys to think about the events. Okay, first imagine a bird, then imagine how the fertilization will happen and how we mentioned, then imagine how they actually give birth to the young ones. Okay, how it will happen, how the process will happen. Acharant, correct. I'm relaunching the poll in the Zoom. You can answer in the poll, and who are in the YouTube live can answer in the YouTube live chat. Okay. Oh, still mistakes are there. Why are you guys making mistake in this much easy question, right? So just think about those process. I told you, like, wherever you are answering a question, it should be a follow up path. Okay, so then only it will lead. Same exactly like key what we studied, right? So first you think about bird, then fertilization, then the nature of the giving birth. Okay, so don't confuse, don't take all the words such as same, because it will make you confused. Okay. Yes, I'm just waiting in YouTube also. Like, only four people answered, I think. Not four people, only two people. Yes. Guys, you still have 10 seconds. Huh? So many people answered correct here. I'm ending the poll in 5 seconds. So someone is missing the class, just notify them that biology class started after like 1 week. Okay, I'm ending the poll now and I'm sharing the results. 72% chosen option A, 14% B, 11% C, and 2% D. And most of you guys are correct. And in YouTube also, everyone gave the correct answer. Correct, right? How reproduction happens. So there will be a male bird and there will be a female bird. What happens? Male bird will transfer the sperms through the process of the copulation, right? Copulation means act of fertilization, okay? Huh, correct. So act of fertilization is called copulation, okay? So coitus, we use several terms, okay? Copulation is one of the term in that. So those sperms will be transferred to the female and there actually fertilization will happen. So fertilization is happening inside the body, okay? So you have two options now. Internal fertilization. Okay. Yeah. You can remove these two words, right? You can remove these two topics. Second one is the process. Is it oviferous or viviferous? Everyone know that birds will give the egg, right? Everyone know that, right? Most of you eaten or probably seen, right? So you can directly go for the here, which answer, the correct answer is option A. Example for external fertilization and viviferous. So example for external fertilization and viviparous, can anybody answer? Remember guys, the eggs may be a calcareous egg as you've seen in the birds, okay? Sometime it may not, okay? When you go for the reptiles, there also the eggs will be a little hard only, okay? But when you go for the little less than that, okay, not in vitro, if you go for the amphibians and all the things, there will be, egg will be laid. Okay, egg will be laid. So literally you have to use the term this one only. Okay, viviparous only, but fertilization will be external. Okay, so that happens. And yeah, so yeah, correct, correct, right. So sometime the egg does not mean that our proper egg, what we can see, chicken egg. It's just a meaning for that, right? The meaning of X will be diversified, right? Diversified. Yes, correct. So dolphin is which group? Where we can add the dolphins? Can anybody answer where we can add? Is it a amphibia? Is it a reptilia? Is it a bird or is it a mammal? Dolphin. Yes, dolphin is a mammal, right? Dolphin is a mammal. Then most of the mammals are placental animals. So they give birth to the young ones. Okay. They don't lay any eggs. So they are viviparous in nature. Yes, correct. Absolutely correct. Okay. So then we are going for the habitat. Okay. Then we are going for a habitat of that. What's the meaning of habitat? Everyone know that, right? Where it can live. Okay. So what is the place it's living? So it can be differentiated into two types. One is aquatic and another is a terrestrial ecosystem, sorry, animals. Okay. So first one is aquatic animals. So aquatic animals means they live or they spend their life in the water. Okay. Either completely or in the most percent of the time. Okay. Why I mentioned most percent of time means you can see some of the fishes are there. Okay. Those what happens, they will live in the ocean, they will fertilize in the ocean, or they burn in the ocean, everything happens there, but or in the river. Okay. But during a particular time, during a time of copulation or egg laying, sometimes they will come back to the this one ground. Okay. Based on that, you can't call them as a terrestrial, okay? Because most of their life cycle, which is present in the aquatic ecosystem only, right? That means in water only. Aquatic means water. I think everyone know that, right? Aqua means water. So you can't call them as a terrestrial. They are aquatic only, okay? So mainly the lower animals, okay? All the lower animals are actually aquatic, most of them, okay? And then you go for in between animals, okay? So some of the amphibians, some of the reptiles, some of the this one mammals like a whale, or then you can go for shark, fish, fishes, right? All of them are actually aquatic animals. Example. So what is terrestrial animals then? Lungfish, correct point, right? So what are terrestrial? Which are living on the land. Terrestrial, terrain means land. Okay, from there the word came from. Terrain, you already know the word. It's a terrestrial means on the land. Okay, so those first animals which came to the lands are amphibians. So you can imagine after the amphibians, reptiles will come. So reptiles are originated in the land. Okay, that's why most of the reptiles are in the land only. And if all of them are land only. So, some of them are show aquatic mode, okay? So, but not completely, right? If you take this one, what you can say, duck or something, they are like, they go for fishing in the river, not completely live there, okay? Nesting and everything happens in the land only, okay? And then mammals, most of the mammals, right? Very few of them are aquatic only, most of the mammals. Because why most of these animals are present in terrestrial? Because they developed here, okay? So that's why most of them find here. Why most of these animals you can find in the aquatic region? Because they developed there, okay? So which contain more population, aquatic or terrestrial? Obviously aquatic only, okay? Obviously aquatic, we have so much population, we still have to find, okay? Like we don't know, we know more, there's one some world called, we know more about moon than about our ocean, okay? They don't live in the water, they live on the water. They live on the water, correct, okay? are aquatic also divided into three groups now. Ha Manvita, yeah, we will see that. Okay, so majorly we can divide like this. Wherever you see a particular organism, we are not at all going for plants. Remember, we go for the plants in the next chapter. Okay, here we only studying about the animals. Those may be aquatic, that means present in water. Some of them may be terrestrial, that may be present in the land. Okay, so types in the freshwater ecosystem. When you go for the eco, oh, one second. Yes. Yes, evolution first happened in the water. That's why more is there. Correct, Vinay. Correct, absolutely correct. Okay. Yes, when you come to the this one, what you can say? Water, aquatic ecosystem. I will mention it here only. Okay, that will be better. Aquatic can be divided into three types. Okay, so what are those three types? So those three types will be freshwater, okay, marine water, and another one is the brackish water. Okay, it's a third one. I will tell the meaning. Okay, so freshwater means the regular freshwater bonds, what you can see, right? So rivers, lakes, ponds and dams, everything is a freshwater. Marine means sea and ocean. Sea and ocean. So yes, so what is the meaning of brackish then? Freshwater means fresh river or pond, lake. Sir, amphibians can be added in this section. Yes, so amphibians are in the initial stage, they will be aquatic and there will be then terrestrial mode. Like if they are what you can say in between, right? That's why we kept it in a separate way. Some of them are completely terrestrial. Some of the frogs are, tree frogs are completely terrestrial. But some of the frogs, if you take, they are completely aquatic. They never come out of the this one water. Okay, so that's also there. Meeting of marine, when marine, this fresh water reaches the marine water, that means when the streams flow and reach the ocean water, they will make estuary, right? Estuary means where actually river is meeting that ocean. There the salt level is completely varying, always varying, right? Those kind of, you call it as the brackish, okay? Where river meets ocean. So that particular one is a brackish. So you can divide like that also, okay, based on that. So simple. So marine, there is no difference, only sea and oceans, all the salt water system, you can say. Freshwater means not salt water. Brackish means in between. So where that river is meeting the ocean, okay? So that you can call it as a brackish, and example will be estuary. Okay, estuary means same, okay? Near delta, correct, Gautam. You can call them delta also. Estuaries, delta, all are same, okay? Then when you come to the freshwater ecosystem, then we again divide into two types, okay? So zooplanktons, nectons, benthic, commander, which division? Manvita, zooplankton is group of organisms, nectar is also group of organisms, benthic is a what you can say part of the ocean. Okay, so there you can again divide into benthic, littoral, all those things, but that's not important here. That's why I didn't mention. When we go for the ecology, there we will study all those things again. Okay, but for information, benthic means below. Okay, benthic, I simply write down here and I will rub it. Okay, benthic means below. That means we normally use this term in the ocean. Okay, ocean or the deep lakes. Which came first, animal or plants? Obviously plants, because those are the food giving, right? If there is no food, how the animals will do? How animals will get ready, right? So, but the issue is you can't say starting organisms as either plants or animals. Those are like none of them. Okay, none of them. These are simple structures. In evolution, we will learn that. Okay, those are complete simple lipid structures, micelles we call it. Okay, like that. So we come back to here. Types of freshwater ecosystem. There's two types are there. Okay, one is a lentic water body. What is the meaning of lentic water body? Lentic means a stagnant water body. Stagnant water body. Okay. So one second, guys. Stagnant water body. What is the examples then? What are the examples then? You can go for pond or lake, okay, all those are lentic. That means water is stagnant, So yeah, so those are stagnant. There is no, it's motionless. You can say that also. Okay, the water outflow is not there. Okay, inflow may be there in some of the areas, but outflow is not there. It's just a stagnant. It's in fresh water. Remember, don't mention ocean and seas as the lentic and lotic. Okay, this is only related to the fresh water system. Okay, it's only related to the fresh water system. Not only artificial, Gautam. So ponds and lakes, not only artificial, there will be some natural also, right? Lakes and ponds, natural also. If you take about any lakes like Chilka or any lakes, those are natural lakes, not artificial. Okay. So whatever, it may be artificial or it may be natural, it's in a confined space or in a stagnant. Okay. So what are lotic then? So lotic means a running water body. Okay. Running water body. So in a simple words. Okay. So running, dam also, you can mention dams also here because these are stagnant. Okay. So even though those are formed from the rivers. Okay. So lotic are the rivers and streams, all those things. Okay. So lotic means water is flowing. Okay. These are actually, correct. Lentic is, I will tell you that one also. Okay. Yes, streams, rivers, falls, everything. Okay. So differentiate this because plants and animal diversity will vary in lentic and lotic water system. Okay. It little bit varies. Oh, yes. So this is a picture of one river. Okay. So lentic water body, yes. You can remember like static. So lentic, static, you can remember like that. If you remember, you can remember the other things. Okay. Sir, in natural lentic water body, aquatic animals are not there. It will be there, Sana. It will be. No issue. If you take any lakes or anything, there will be some aquatic animals, right? And how to remember? If you are from Karnataka, you can remember like lotic, like ota. Ota means running, right? Ota, lota. So lotic means ota or running. So you can remember like that also. Okay. So remember anyone, either lentic or lotic. So you can remember the other one easily. Okay. So lentic means a stagnant and lotic means a stream or flowing one. Okay. So remember those things. So any doubts guys regarding this particular one regarding habitat and this one? Sometimes what in dams water will be released. That time it will become lotic. It will be a river, right? Seas and oceans, no. I told you, right? These are only types of freshwater system. So sea and ocean, we never differentiate. Those are simple. Sea or ocean are marine system. Okay. So these are freshwater. Remember, I told you that one only. Low flow. Guys, wherever river is there, that's floating. Okay. Wherever water is not flowing, then only it's landing. Okay. Collect like that. Then there will be habit. Okay. Habit means you know that, right? How you are interacting and all these things. What's your habit? We'll normally ask, right? We based on that, we will made 5 different kinds of habit, more than that also. But this much is enough for our study. So I'm just making a bracket here. Okay. So don't think that these are the only ones, but these are the important ones. You should remember. Others, if the words came, then I will explain. Okay. So first one is a solitary. Solitary means they live alone. Okay. So they never mingled with anything. So example is cricket. Okay. Or grasshopper. You can take an example of grasshopper. So as you can see, those are alone. They simply feeding themselves and they simply know lions are not solitary. Okay. Lions are not solitary. So they simply roaming. So those are a solitary. Second one is a colonial. Okay. Colonial means they live in groups and help each other. If you take an example of which example we can give, there's only right honeybee or termite, honeybee, termite, okay, or any other ants, okay, all those organisms, what they will do? They will live in a colony, okay, in a group, and they will help each other. Like a honeybee, there will be some workers will be there, some queen will be there, some drone will be there, some nesting will be there, okay. Some are builders will be there. Okay. They're like, colony, like us, correct. Okay. Live in groups and help each other. There are some others are there. They also live in groups, but do not help each other. Example is locusta. Probably you already heard this term, locusta storms, which harm our agriculture, all those things, right? So So remember, grasshopper and locust look similar because both of them include in a similar order. So, okay, but they are not exactly same. Grasshoppers will be grass-like, grainish something. But locust will be much larger, okay, more vivid colors. Okay, plague of locust, correct, right? These locusts are gregarious in nature. That means they live in a groups, but they do not help in each other, okay? Yes, they will eat our crops, they will pass away, and they will like go in a complete herd, thousands, lakhs of locusts will be there, but they never help each other, okay? They are completely act like a solitary, but what happens? They will in a groups, okay? So remember the difference between a colonial and gregarious, okay? Yes, gregarious pest we call it, is correct, Manita. And it's a parasite. That means it depends upon the others, like ticks, mites, all those things, okay? Dragonflies are actually, they are living in groups sometimes, but they do not help in each other, correct? Some of them are solitary, actually. Yes, parasitic, what about human? You know that human, what it is, do you think? Human is colonial always, okay? Yes, parasites, ticks, mites, leeches. Okay, probably you saw some of these ticks, mites, or leeches. They actually depend upon the others for their food and nutrition. Okay, so those are called parasites. And last one is sessile or sedentary. That means fix it to a particular substrate. Okay, fix it to the a particular substrate like a porifera or a sponge. Okay, they never move from that particular spot. They will always stick to that particular spot. Okay. So they never move anyway. So they will be there only. Okay. So what about lions? Okay. So what about lions, guys? What do you think? Is it a solitary or colonial or gregarious, parasitic, sessile or sedentary? Kind of. Okay. But I told you, right? There are some others also there. Those are not included. I'm not mentioned here. I only went for a major thing. Okay. Not gregarious. Lions are present in a herds, especially the females. Okay, there the changes happens. If you take an example of elephants or the lions, the males will always roam within the territory, but the females, those mothers, those grandmothers, those children, they live in a family. Okay, and they hunt in a family. Okay, they hunt in a family and they live in a family. So that's why we don't call it as a solitary. Okay. When they are in a mating season, then only the males will act like a solitary. That means they live alone and they will try to find the mate, suitable mate. So that's what, when you go for a higher organism, so the association will be a little complex. Okay. Hatanmai. I don't understand. So I'm not going to read also. Okay. So that happens. Yes. So next one question came. So while you are solving any question, if you have any doubt, you can ask. Okay. The question is, species diversity will be rich in lentic water body, lotic water body, marine water body, estuarine water body. Okay. I am launching the poll. I relaunched the poll, and who are in the YouTube can answer in the YouTube live chat. Okay. So what is species diversity? Before answering, just remember, species diversity means the number of species within a geographical area, okay, within a particular geographical area. If I take a 1 kilometer square of then where the species will be rich? Is it in lentic, lotic, marine or estuarine? Is it not like, what you can say, number of this ones? No issue, Tanmay. Okay. So don't think that they be told in the freshwater and marine. I told like marine only have lot of species. Aquatic have more species. This one terrestrial are less species like that. Okay. Estuarine, meaning of estuarine. Estuarine means a brackish water. Okay. Brackish water. Okay. I'm just checking the pool. So it's better if I left this question. Okay, I'm just waiting for the answer. Okay, I'm ending the poll, guys. So just tell me now. I'm sharing the results. 18% chosen option A, 11% B, 65% chosen C and 7% chosen D and stopped sharing their results. And what made you think about that particular answers? So some of you chosen A, B, C, D. What made you feel that choosing that particular answer only, not anything else? So what made you feel? So just answer in like one or two words. So just for our information, okay? So why you guys choose that answer? Just I want to give it. Vast body, yes. But we told you, right? A species diversity in particular area, 1 kilometer square. You consider marine hole, huh? I don't know him, I didn't say. Marine has more adaptation, okay? Yes. Same as so many kinds of species present. Yeah, correct, Nayana. Haven't more polluted. Sir, estuaries meaning Manvita, this one, right? We told you, brackish water, where river meets the, this one. Acharanth, you raised your hand, I didn't understand. If you have any doubt, just put it in this one. Because there will be stagnant, antique, okay. Mixture of both type of water, huh, correct, Tejas? Yes, correct, okay. So, yes, Atlantic and Lotic both are related to the freshwater only. And marine means, you know that, okay. Yes, correct. So when you compare marine and the freshwater system, everyone knows that marine water body have more species diversity compared to the freshwater system. So A and B is not the answer. Okay. But then we again have to consider. Okay. There's a marine and there's estuarine water body where you can find more different kinds of the or types of the species diversity. Then we can go for the nature of that. Okay. Marine water will be salty and organisms are originated. That is absolutely correct. Freshwater will be without any salt and later organisms come to there. Okay. Developed or went to there. Okay. Estuarine is having the goods of both worlds. Okay. It have a salt, but it's not too salty. So it's like an in-between stage, okay? So that's what attracts most of the organisms, okay? That's what attracts the most organisms. The correct answer is estuarine water body, okay? It's an in-between. Those organisms which is present in freshwater also sometimes they visit estuarines, and the marine also, marine animals also visit the estuaries. So it made estuaries are most diversified than the this one, okay. Other two kinds of systems, okay. So that's what the importance of the this one estuaries, okay. Why we are always telling we have to conserve the estuaries. Which one? You can take an example of the this one, Brahmaputra and Ganga river delta will be there, right? Why we are so concentrated about estuaries? Because those have so unique animals and also the some of the breeding ground for the this one ocean animals, okay, ocean organisms, and breeding ground for the aquatic or freshwater animals, and they are also having some unique organisms which is only restricted to estuaries, okay. So that's what make estuaries are most diversified than that, okay. Yes, most of them are not adjusted to salt resistance. Correct, Mohan. Your answer is correct. I know. So estuaries means I'm writing again a river where river meets ocean. Okay. But when you consider the number of whole species, okay, number of whole species, then it will goes to marine only because marine is a whole large water body. Okay. That's why I told not to consider complete the water system. So that's what makes the difference. Okay. So, okay, we'll go for the next one. Next one is based on time of activity. We again divide into two types. So these are simple. One is a diurnal. Diurnal means what? Those are active during daytime. Okay. Oh, I'll change the color. Yes. Active during daytime. Remember this term. Okay. Daytime. These are called diurnal. Okay. Don't confuse the word with diuretic. Okay. Diuretic means the process of getting urination. Okay. The process of getting urination is diuretic. And this is diurnal. Diurnal means active during the daytime. Okay. Don't confuse with the words. Don't write like diuretic or something like that. It will be completely messed up the meaning. Okay. And the next one is a nocturnal. Nocturnal means which are active during the night time. Okay. Night time active. So diurnal, you know that we are the diurnals and most of the animals are diurnals. Okay. Nocturnal. And then you will learn to know. Now you don't know. Okay. No, Nishita. Even though we are active during both day and night, except the electricity, remove all the artificial things. If you remove all the artificial things, then which time you will be active? We will be active during the daytime only, right? So we will be diurnal. Okay. Anisha Chari. Correct. Okay. Yeah. So diurnal example will be most of the mammals, like us. Not most of the mammals, like I can't say like that, right? Humans, cows, or horse, you can say all this example. Nocturnal, you can go for the this one, owl, okay, or some of the this what you can say, animals like deer, all those things. Those are not actually bats, not ghosts, okay. Bats, cats, they changed, okay. No, Manita, I will tell you. Okay. So, yes. Deers are actually diurnal only one time, but due to the humanization and all the things, we made those organisms to change the activity to the night time, okay, based on our impact. Okay. What about dogs? Most of those organisms will be diurnal only, active during the daytime, but they can weave in the night. That does not mean they are nocturnal, okay. Diurnal is exactly like what we talked about aquatic and terrestrial, in which time they are mostly active. That's what makes, okay. But ants, sir, okay, so those organisms also, even the insects also follow the time of activity, okay. Yes, in some of the insects, look, it's never depend upon that particular phylum, okay. It's always dependent upon that particular species, okay. If you take cats, regular our cats will be diurnal, okay, but some of the cat species will be nocturnal, okay. If you take insects, honeybees is a diurnal, okay, but moths are nocturnal, okay. So it's always about a particular species, not about a group of species, okay. Mosquitoes will be completely different group that we discuss in a later. Okay, they will only active during the dawn and dusk. That means morning and evening. That will be different. Okay. How deer are nocturnal? No, not all are nocturnal. They are actually diurnal only. But wherever human presence is there, that particular region deers are turned into a nocturnal, because morning the time hunting and poaching, everything will be done. Nocturnal, it will be reduced because of that particular issue. Okay. So which animal is active during both day and night? I'm not sure about that. Okay. I'm not sure which one is active during the both day and night. Okay. But every organism needs rest. It should rest in one. Okay. Activity, that will be different. Okay. So just remember these things. Yeah, dog is diurnal only, Anuradha. Okay, so remember about these things based on the time of the activity. I thought of telling one thing, but I forgot. Okay, like do fishes sleep? Do sleeps will be different? Okay, the meaning of sleeps will be you can say it a rest. They will take a rest. The part of sleep is exactly rest to our brains. The part of our brains will, part of their brains take rest, or some of them actually take rest. Okay. Yes. So the, these are based on the activity of when they active. Okay. That's what makes them important. So next one is early classification. I'm not going in detail. Porifera are, they are continuous. Okay. They are not coming in any one of that, because they will be present deep in the ocean. Okay. So early classification happens by the Aristotle. It is not evolving is different. It's just acclimatization. That means adapting to the new changes. Yes. Hibernation, we will learn, Sajin. No issue. Okay. It's a sleep. It's a summer sleep. Okay. So, yeah. Early classification will be simple. Anima and anima. So, anima means what? Anima means without RBC. Right, without red blood, without not RBC, without red blood. So anima means blood. So they thought blood will be red always. Okay. So without red blood will be the anemia. And what is anemia? Having red blood. Okay, having red blood will be anemia. But these are early classification. We will already learned about this in the first chapter, second chapter, right? So I'm not going to explain it once again. Okay, anemia is a disease. Huh? Anemia means blood actually. That's why all those things are related. Okay. Plato, we probably taught you in the first chapter, first slide, this one, I think. This lines and poster active boot and night. Yes, Kanika, I told you, right? These things, these cats having different kinds of nature based on the species. I told you, right? Even deer also, those are depend upon that particular situation and all the things. We will say that. Okay. But sometime we will say with respect to the groups also. So that always happens. Lions hunts in the this also, but I'm not sure that this complete active during day and night. I'm not sure about that. Okay, some of them will be day and some of them will be night. I'm not sure. Bullfrog never rest. We'll check on that. Okay, so one question came. Question is simple. Answer this, then we go for some of the in detail about certain things. Okay, nocturnal animals can see objects better in night time because their eyes have more cones than rods, more rods than cones, compound eyes, both A and C. This is what I thought of explaining. Okay, somebody asked about compound eyes and simple eyes. I thought of explaining, then I forgot. I will explain here. Okay, I'm relaunching the poll, so you can answer in the poll. So who are in the YouTube live can answer in the YouTube live chat. I just want more responses, guys, from YouTube. Okay, you know what it is, just respond it, no issue. Okay, it may be right or wrong. And I don't know who asked the question about component simple. Sorry, I forgot the things. Okay. Without hemoglobin, what are the possible colors of the blood? Manvita, it will be blue, it will be white, it will be green. Okay. It will be slightly yellowish. Okay. There are like colors are there. Hemocyanin, different kinds are there in that one. We will also learn that while we are studying the phylum. I think rods and cones probably came in the 10th class, right? 10th or 9th? 10th or 9th? Where rods and cones of the eyes came actually? 10th, right? Huh. I'll show. One second, actually. Once we complete this one, I will show, okay? Huh, 10th, right? Yeah. So that's why I didn't explain that. Huh, in 8th also. Then you should know that, yeah. I'm giving another one 10 seconds. Such type of eyes, Chandan, I didn't understand. Such type of eyes, I didn't understand. Like, what kind of eyes? I'm ending the poll, guys. Answer quickly. Yes. In textbook, syllabus was given. Huh. Colors. Okay, okay, I will tell you. Okay. Yeah. Sharing the results. 15% chosen option A, 27% chosen option B, 25% chosen option C, and 33% chosen option D. Hi, Shiva. I'm stop sharing the results. Okay. So, yes, you can see it. What are these color represents, actually? What are these colors represent? What cones help? Huh. Yes, Inchara. It has hemocyanin kind of. Yep. So, what cones represent? Is it for the colored vision or is it for black and white vision? Anybody? 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 And just answer in a single word. Correct. Yes, correct, right. So you can simple like that. The cones which is present in our eyes for colored vision. C for cones, C for color. So it's easy to remember, right? C for cones and C for color. You can directly remember this. So if you remember the cones, you can remember about the rods also. Rods which help in the night vision, or you can say intensity. Okay. It help in the intensity of light. Okay. Intensity of light. So wherever you are using, you are seeing different colors. That's majorly because of your cones. Okay. And during the night time, still you can observe little things. But in those light condition or in the night condition when there is very less light is there, then you can't differentiate proper colors, right? Because those times cones are not active, rods are active. Those rods are just helping intensifying that particular light. Okay, so it's like a black and white vision. It's not actually black and white vision rods, but those are majorly work in the intensity of light, and cones are majorly work on the color. So nocturnal animals needs what? Nocturnal animals needs increase in the intensity of night, not about the colors, right? Because we are diurnals, we already have a light. So only thing we have to do is like we have to take the colors. Okay. Ha, correct. That's mistaken. Okay, no issue. So those night vision or the nighttime or nocturnal animals needs more rods. The correct answer is having more rods than the cones. Those organisms have more rods. So those intensity of light absorption will be like more. Okay. That's why bats can see more clearly in the night, but they can't see clearly in the daytime because intensity will be too high. It will make the things very bright. Okay. So that's why they can't see during the daytime. Okay. Because it's like too much bright for them. But in the nighttime, it's suitable for them. Okay. That's opposite to us. Okay. So other organisms, cats and canidae and these felidae organisms, they have a mixed kind of things. That means cones also will be there, and rods also will be there in a little bit higher percentage. So that will help them. Okay. That's what helped them in dogs and cats. Okay. Those visions are not exactly equals to the owls, but it's still better than the humans. Okay. In case of owls, correct. Okay. What is compound eyes? Compound eyes, in the insects, what happens? Instead of having a single eye, insect have multiple eyes. Okay. Insect will have the multiple eyes like this. Okay. We use a different terms. There is no need now. Okay. More rods, more greater vision. Correct. Okay. So what they will do, each single this section will perceive the image and they will give the image like in this manner. Okay. What you can see in a single, this insect will see in a multiple screen. Okay. It's exactly like TV shops. What happens? You can watch cricket in TV shops in like 30, 40 different TVs, right? Exactly like this. But the clarity will be less. Okay. Humans have a simple eyes. In compound eyes, they have a more visions, okay, but the clarity is less. Okay, clarity is less comparatively. So they can sense the motion. So if you take an example of this one, housefly, if your hand is coming from here, they can sense and they can fly off. Okay, but because they can sense your hand in all these TVs, okay, eyes. But the clarity is comparatively less. So that's why in a higher organism, you can find the simple eyes, because simple eyes have the more clarity. Okay. What means eagle's eye more sharper? Not only eagle's eye, Mohan, like different organisms, depending upon their habitat, the changes will happen in the eye pattern. Okay. The presence of the cones, presence of rods, the distance between the particular upper region to the lower regions. Okay. How many neurons are connected? Everything all matters today. Okay. Advantage of compound eyes. Those are developed in the insect. Those you can sense the motions very easily. Okay. So those are like in the lower organisms in the evolution tree, not in the higher. In higher, you can only find the simple eyes, not the compound eyes. Okay. That's actually a fail actually. Humans are complex. Yes, not only humans. All the mammals have the complex eyes. Okay. All the mammals have the complex eyes. Yes, we are going to the next one. We learn about your eyes and everything later also. Okay. One more time. So outline of classification. So how we classified that? It's just an outline, not in detail. Okay. So first we made a kingdom, that means Animalia. Then we took the level of organization, cellular level and tissue or other level. In cellular level, you can only find one phylum, that will be phylum Porifera. Okay. But when you take all the other tissue, organ or organ system level, you again stuck with several other groups. Then we to go for the symmetry, which are radially symmetrical, which you divide into cylindrata and tenophora. This one is 2, 2nd and 3rd. And these are, even though biradial, but majorly it will show radial, we kept it in a radial only, okay? Then others we kept it in bilateral symmetry. You know about the bilateral symmetry, I'm not going once again. Within the bilateral, we again have some of the other phylum. So we took care of the body cavity or coelom. Some of them do not have the coelom. We kept it like Platyhelminthes, and some of them have pseudo coeloms. We made a separate phylum like Ascalminthes. We have the true coelom. Then we again kept it these things. These are again divided based on the some other character like embryonal characters and egg character, okay, or and segmentation characters, all those things. But those are not included in the textbook. That's why I just left it like that. But knowing this much is enough, okay? So these are included in the coelom. Those are Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinoderms, Hemichordates, and Chordates. And this chapter is very, 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 very important, okay? So what you can see, these are VVVIMP. Okay, so you should know about this chart. Now, there are several questions they will ask directly based on this particular chart only. Okay, so this is the outline. So these are the phylums we will study. So Porifera, Cnidaria, Ctenophora, Platyhelminthes, Ascalminthes, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, Hemichordata, and Chordata. Hemichordata is categorized under the subphylum in the old classification. Now it's kept in a separate phylum. You may ask, where is the Cephalochordata and Urochordata? All those are subphylum which is comes under the Chordata. Okay, so when we go for the Chordata, there we will see the classification of Chordata regarding to the subphylum. Okay, so major things are phylums are only 11 only. Okay, only we have 11 phylums. So you have to remember all the 11 phylum. That is really, really important. Guys, any doubts regarding any particular words or meanings that we discussed? If you don't have any doubt, if you think we can move on, click on yes. Okay, otherwise, if you have any doubt, just put a this one, or can doubt in the chat box, okay, in YouTube and also in the Zoom live. Okay. Yes, I'm just waiting. Yes, okay. So I'm just waiting for 1 minute for any doubts to come. Okay, remember guys, I'm not repeating these things once again when we are discussing about the phylum, okay, because it will take a lot of time. That's why I took two class only to explain the terms, okay. So just to make sure about it and read it, okay. How to pronounce two, okay. In 11 phylums, remembering the 11 phylums is difficult, but once you made a habit, like once you read it like 2 to 4 times, then automatically it will come. Okay, automatically it will come. There is no need of any hard. So simple eyes and compound eyes. Maulya, simple eyes means having a single eye. Compound eyes means having more sensor within a single eye in the insects. Okay, compound eyes you can only see in lower organisms. And those are evolutionary present in lower organisms only, not that much of important, but simple eyes are more prominent and present in the higher organisms. Okay. Then how to Cnidaria. You just mentioned to Cnidaria. C is silent in there. In Cnidaria, C is silent. It's just a Cnidaria, not Cnidaria. Okay. It's just a Cnidaria. Yes. Here is also right. Ctenophora, not Ctenophora. It's just a Ctenophora. Okay. So silence, C are silence. I don't know why. Don't ask me why C is silent. Okay. Cephalochordates and urochordates, everything comes under the chordates as a subphylum. Okay. Cephalochordates, urochordates are the subphylums. So which comes under the chordates. We will learn that in the chordates. Yes. Okay, then we will move on to our the next thing, that is Porifera or sponge. Okay. So what is the meaning of Porifera? Do you know this person? Sir, write in order wise or middle wise. Or it's better to write in order wise, Hemashri. Okay. Sir, where are the extinct animals classified? So extinct animals are some of them included in here, some of them included in a separate, but we don't study that in here because this is too complex to understand, because only one or two examples will be there. So that's why those are not included in here. Okay, but most of them are included in this particular 11 only. Yes. Ha, SpongeBob, correct, right. Porifera is word actually came from the word having porous, okay? And fera means to bear, okay? To bear. So that means having a pore, okay? Literally meaning having a pore, okay? Having pores, okay? So this one of the example of this one, look how nice it is, how beautiful it is, right? Yes, so porifera is the first organisms, actually. These are the first multicellular organisms, okay? First multicellular organisms developed, and this contains almost more than 5,000, K means 1,000, okay? Remember the word, okay? 5,000 species are there. Don't again ask what's the meaning of K. K means 1,000, okay? We normally use the term, right? 1K, 2K, okay? So, yes. Sir, between white, what's the peach color? Do they have significance? I didn't understand, Manita. White, what's the peach color? This one. You're asking about where is the peach color? I didn't know what is peach. Okay, how do we consider porifera as animals? Are they attached like plants? It is attached to the land. Just I told you, right? Animals can be attached to the land. That's what we call it as the sessile. Okay. That's what we call them as the sessile organism. Okay. No. Peripheras are later developed later. Okay. So these are later. In the animals, multicellular organism. I can't say organism, right? Multicellular animals. Yes. Okay. So I didn't understand peach color. Probably you are asking about this. I'm not sure about it. Probably it's some debris or something. Okay. I'm not sure about that one. Okay. So these are the first multicellular animals and have more than 5,000 species. Okay. And they contain the spores. That's the significance of those. Okay. That's the significance of those organisms. So we will go for in detail about these things. Okay. So first one is the habitat. Where it is present. Can anybody answer? So you know the meaning of habitat, right? So you can answer easily. So where it will present? Habitat. So it's terrestrial, aquatic, yes. All of them are aquatic. All of them are aquatic. Mainly marine. Okay. Few are freshwater. Okay. So can you name the freshwater sponge? Yes, correct. The freshwater sponge will be spongilla. Okay, we will see the photo later. Okay, spongilla is the freshwater. All the other will be aquatic, marine. Okay, they developed in the marine, so most of them are marine only. But you can say they are aquatic. Okay, you can say they are aquatic. What is body form then? Body form means how the body is made. Those are having porous body structure. Okay, porous body structure. That means body is there, but it's having so many pores. Okay, yes, so many pores. Cellular organization, we will come to that later. Okay, they have a porous kind of body structures. And what is the symmetry? They are asymmetrical, right? Asymmetrical. So, yes, asymmetrical. Few looks radial. Okay. Probably I kept one more yes or something. Asymmetrical and few looks like radial. I told looks like radial, not radial, because there are some species are there, okay, polycythemidia or some other species, they call it radial. Some of them call it as radial. They only look like radial. So that's why we stick to the asymmetrical. Okay, majorly they are asymmetrical. Some of them looks like that only. Okay. And what are the germ layers? Is it diploblastic or triploblastic? You can answer. Yes, absolutely. These are diploblastic animals. Okay, these are diploblastic animals. That means having ectoderm and endoderm only, which is having mesoglia. Okay, correct. And level of organization. Now you can say, what's the level of organization? It is the cellular level of organization. Okay, Now I understand, right? When you know the meaning of those words, it's like super easy to go, right? Super easy to go because you already know that, just you have to mention it. So next one is the body wall. Okay, this is really important, guys. This is really, really, really important. Okay, so don't forget about it. This is also important, very, very important. Okay. Correct. So how the body wall is formed, we will discuss from that. Okay. So remember about the sponges, they have a body wall like this. I will take a different color. I will take somewhat red. Okay. Correct. Naina. Porous body structure means ostia only. I will mention where it is. Body structures contain ostia and osculum. I thought I will explain it later, then I will mention it here. Okay. Correct. You are absolutely correct. Okay. So here you can see, if I take a sponge and you can zoom in, okay, no issue, you can zoom in your screen. So if you take any sponge like this, if I take a section, okay, how it will look like? It will look like this, okay, it will look like this. It's just a section of this one, okay, longitudinal section, right? Longitudinal section. So in that, what are the body walls then? Okay, body walls means what are the cells which is present in this wall like structure, right? So as you can see, it have two kinds of the opening, or you can say pores. One is the ostium, okay, those are smaller pores which is present to the longitudinal or to the sideways, okay, and only one larger pore called osculum. Okay, so remember, ostium means what? Ostium means a small pores along the sides of the particular animal, and vasculum means a large pore which is present in the top way. Okay, which is present in the top way. What's the function? We will see that later. Okay, remember only that much. So how can we differentiate a body wall? Okay, so we can differentiate body wall into majorly three types. Okay, there are some other types also there. Okay, ostia and ostium are same. Yes, sir. Singular and plural. In biology, wherever singular and plural, you can simply think about M, okay, ostia and osculum. So you probably heard some other words also, right, similar to that. So yes, so body walls are majorly divided into three types, okay, majorly I'm telling you. So one is a pinacoderm. Remember, this is a dermal layer. What's the meaning of derma? Can anybody answer meaning of derma? Abscidia, abscidium, right? Skin, right? Yes. Derma means skin. Exactly. Here is also same. Where you can find the skin then? Here, where you can find the skin? These are skin, right? These are skin. So these are the pinacocytes. Okay. Pinacocytes are actually the dermal cells, or the cells which is present above that particular surface. Okay. So these are again divided into two types. Okay. So we simply call it as pinacocytes. Remember, wherever the word cytes coming, cytes means cell, okay, cells. So there are again divided into pinacocytes. Pinacocytes means these cells which are present along this way. And the second one is the porocytes. What are porocytes? Porocytes are the cells. Here you can see, right, porocytes are the cells which are helping them to make a pore-like structure, okay, or you can say ostia, okay. So structure which is making a ostia are actually porocytes, and the structure which are making or layering are called the pinacocytes, okay, remember. So I'm repeating, body wall, first one is a pinacoderm. Yes, correct. Pinacoderm divided into pinacocytes and sporocytes. Derm in skin layers, pinacocytes layer the outer covering. Porocytes will layer the pores or the holes. Porocytes lining the ostia. Correct. Correct. Okay. Yes. So what is the function of them? One is a protective in function. And what is the second function? These actually form ostia. That's also its function. Okay. Form the ostia. That's also its function. So second one is the conoderm. Okay. Yes. Conoderm. Conoderm are containing plagellated conocytes or collar cells. Just remember here, one sec, I'm just taking different colors. Yes, answer guys. Okay, yes. I want to change the color, it's not changing. Ha, huh, correct, absolutely. Correct, Anirudha. Okay, so conoderm, so cono means color cells, okay. Here you can see to the internal, here you can see a small cells like this, okay. If I zoom this particular conocytes or color cells, it will be like this, okay. It will be like this. As you can see, one cell is here, and cell is having a collar-like appearance, collar-like structure, and it also have a flagella, right? So why it's called collar cell or conocytes? These cells are actually present inside or internal side of that particular sponge, okay? So why is it helping then? How is it helping then? When water enters through the ostium, these conocytes or collar cells move their flagella, okay, and help in the flow of water current from here to the here, okay. If there is no movement, if there is no pump, then what happens? The water will stagnant, right? What will be stagnant? It should be completely dependent upon the water current. It may be come from here, here. It will be like turbulent, right? So they develop the flagellas. Those flagellas will help in the moving the water from this direction to the above direction. Okay, from ostia to the osculum, you can see. So that's the function of the conoderms, or you can say collar cells. Okay, so wherever you are using the conoderm means a layer of cells. Okay, and those are containing what kind of cells? Conocytes. What are conocytes? If they ask, these are flagellated cells. Help in the movement of water current in the phylum Porifera. Okay, so we went outside, we went inside, right? We went outside and we went inside. Then what's left to us? Left to us is the inside, right? Outside is completed, inside is completed. Middle, what is present in between, right? Yes, middle layer is called mesohyl layer. Okay, mesohyl layer, is it, you can think this one like mesenchyma. Okay, kind of like a mesenchyma. You can think like a mesenchyma. Okay, so what it contain? This contains several type of the cells. Okay, several types of the cells are present. But what you can see, majorly there's a non-cellular middle layer, non-cellular, what you can see here. Okay, it's majorly rich with the water and containing the fibers, spicules and amebocytes. What is fiber? You know that fibers are the actually kind of protein structure. Okay, so actin fiber, all the other fiber what you can see in humans, right? Similar kind. What are spicules then? Okay, spicules are actually a hard structure. Okay, hard structure made up of either calcium carbonate, that's called calcaceous, or they're made up of the silica, they are called as siliceous. Okay, siliceous. So what they are doing then? Spicules are like, how we can say, these are actually rods to our home. What we'll do when we are constructing our home, we will put rods, right? Exactly same kind. These spicules are hard structures. What you can see here, right? These are spicules. Okay, these are pillars, like pillars. Okay, these spicules will give the initial a hard structure to that. Okay, initial hard structure to that particular complete structure. Okay, middle mesoglia, Manvita. Mesoglia only present in the embryo stage. Okay, later it will turn into mesohyl. Okay, is they are solid and fluid in nature. In the internal, this mesohyl is more like a, what you can say, jelly kind of nature. Okay, it is not completely solid, not completely liquid. It's like a middle kind of a what you can say, a high viscous liquid like that. Okay, so it contains spicules. That spicules may be made up of calcium carbonate or made up of the silica. Okay, and they also contain amebocytes and also contain the fibers. All of them gives little strength to the strength to that particular layer. Okay, then what is the important cell in this? This is the amoeboid cells. Okay, what's the importance of amoeboid cells? Why we call it as amoeboid cells? Because they show amoeba like movement. Okay, they will show the amoeba like movement. Don't think that amoeba is there. Okay, amoeba like movement it will show. That's why we call it as amoebocytes, amoeba like cells. They are totipotent. What is the meaning of totipotent? Can give other type of cells. Yes, I'm going to that. Can give other type of cells. Type of cell and can differentiate continuously. Can differentiate continuously. I'll tell the meaning in simple words. Okay. Continuously. So what's the meaning of that? Wherever the you will take any cells, those cells can't divide continuously. If you take your skin cell, it can only divide for 50 times. Okay, 51 times. They, later it will stop this one dividing. But there are some cells are there, like our bone marrow cells or embryo cells or plant cells or this amoebocytes. These can divide continuously without any halt. Okay, without any halt, they can divide continuously. Okay. Those kind of cells, continuously dividing cells are called totipotent. The importance is these amoebocytes can divide and form the other type of cells. Means there are some other types of cells are there. Those are called either nerve cells or that means some of them helping in the nursing or some of them will be sperm, some of them will be egg. Some of them will be forming the spicules. Some of them will forming the pinacocytes. Some of them will forming the chondrocytes. Sorry. All of them can be found from the amoebocytes. Remember, amoebocytes can give what? It can give any type of cell in that particular animal. Okay. It may give from the pinacocytes, chondrocyte, to it can give rise to a sperm and egg. Okay. So that kind of nature amoebocytes have. That's the importance. Okay. And this is the one which is actually helping in the sending the message and doing all the work. Okay. Amoebocyte is like a transferring tissue, like a RBC in our body, but the changes is like this is help in the it can be divide and form the some other types of the cells also. These are the three different types of cells and importance. Okay. Whatever bones will be constantly replaced in our whole lifetime. Yes, our bones, the calcium in our bones will be continuously replaced until the age. Okay, and up to a particular age. Then that will be reduced. There are like some cells are there. We will see that. Okay. So body wall can be divided into pinacoderm, conoderm, and mesohyal layer. Pinacoderm is a dermal layer which is protective in function. Okay. So contain pinacocytes which form outer sites and porocytes which actually hold that particular ostium. Okay. Conoderms contain flagellated conocytes or collar cells help in moving the water current. Mesohyal layers or non-cellular middle layers containing fibers, spicules. Spicules are hard structure made up of either calcium or silica and having amoebocytes. Amoebocytes are very, very important because they show amoeboid-like movement and they are totipotent. That means can differentiate continuously and can give rise to other types of cells also. Okay. So we will see, Sachin. Okay, sponges, seal, what is all those things? We will learn that in the next slides. Okay. So I launched the teacher NPS. Okay. So you can answer the teacher NPS. And what we can do is like, so before coming to the, after you completing this one, after you completing this particular one, yes. So before coming to the next class, please read about these things. Okay. Then we can move on smoothly about the other examples. So I'm going for the first slides because some people are asking for the first slide. Okay. Any doubts you can ask now. So I'm just waiting from the YouTube also. So in YouTube also, if you have any doubt regarding today's topic, you can ask now. Okay. So don't think about some others because we still have to study more about the periphera. Like sponge cells, how is the osculum, how is the canal system, and how reproduction will happen, how circulation will happen, all those things we will study in tomorrow class, okay? Not tomorrow, day after tomorrow, okay? Seal means you can simply think such a, like cavity, sponge means sponge, okay? The cavity which is present in the sponge is this on the seal, symbol. Amoebocytes once again, yes. Amoebocytes are cells which can have the movement like amoeba, okay? And the important thing is they are totipotent. I am repeating the meaning of totipotent one more time. Totipotent means these cells can differentiate continuously without any halt, okay, without any stop. Okay, so those are cells are called totipotents. If you take a single plant cell, from the single plant cell, it can completely make a complete whole new plant body. Okay, so exactly same here. A single type, single cell can differentiate into a completely new body of that particular organism. That's called totipotent. That's the ability of the amebocytes, and they will form the other types of cells. That means when chondrocytes are not there, that amebocytes will convert into chondrocytes. When conocyte is not there, that amebocyte will turn into conocyte. Some other structure like porocyte is not there, it will turn into like that. When reproduction is happening, it will turn into sperm and egg. Okay, so it can do all those multiple work. Okay, so that's why amebocytes are very important. Yes, any more on doubts? So is it cellular level of organization, but why not tissue? Tissue, we know this one meaning, right? Tissue means having similar origin, doing the same work, function in the same work. Okay, but as you can see here, even though these cells are doing a similar kind of work, they are not attached to one another. That means they are not bind to one another work. Okay, so tissue, what happens if you give them a work, everyone will join and do the work. Okay, but these conocytes are not like that. Any cell of this periphery is not like that. They do their individual work, but the individual work will give rise to some, a result. Okay, that's why we can't say it's a tissue level. You have to say it like cellular level. Yes. Mesohyle is a non-cellular part which contain the amebocyte cells. Okay, this is not a layer. That's what I mean, Charan. Okay, mesohyle is a non-cellular part means, is it not a layer or dermal layer? It's just a space with some liquid kind of structure which contain all the cells and all the other structure. Non-cellular means not at all contain a single cell, not that mean. It simply means it's not a dermal layer. Okay. How ability come to amebocytes to behave like a totipotent? We don't know about that. How the ability came, we don't know that. But it is the important ability, so which remained from the embryo stage, because those kind of nature we can only see in embryo cells. Okay, so those nature is actually remained in the amebocytes. That's what made them special. Okay. So what we call like totipotent and differentiate into anything, those are the actual character of the embryo cells of the embryo. Okay, so that remained there probably for the restoration of the body and all the things. I think where is the food is absorbed, that we study tomorrow. Okay, not absorbed, actually it's food will be taken through the single cells take that. So osculum means single opening which is present above that particular sponge. Okay, single external opening. So you can think osculum as an anus. Okay, ostium as a mouth. Okay, it will have several mouths but single osculum. Okay, so is food or anything passes from ostia to osculum to the sponge? Yes, starts from ostium. This is the spongocyte and this is the osculum. Okay, ostia, spongocyte, osculum. That we learn in tomorrow. Sir, yes, join the meeting around 6:29. Yes, you guys go and join who are actually there for that particular program. Those can leave. Show the slides of early classification of animals. Okay, Akshay. So I'm going to that one. So early classification. Yes, early classification. No, Nandesh, not for you. Only few of the students have that one. Spongocele means seal. Seal means cavity, not coelom kind of. In coelom also, seal means cavity only, right? Seal means cavity. Sponge means sponge. The cavity which is present inside the sponge is spongocele. That's it. Easy. Okay. Thank you. Yes, guys, any more doubt? Then I will close the YouTube live. Okay. So we will meet day after tomorrow, guys. Please read the things. Okay, please read the things and come to the next class. I'm ending the stream. Bye-bye. No, only.